First man into space. This is an Italian.
Yep.
Oh, I have the U.S. one sheet for this here, and I had a quad recently. I married a monster from outer space.
The U.S. paper is actually not all that interesting on this, I found.
No.
For how
I recognize the claw and the face,
yeah,
but this graphic is so much better than the quad or the American. The graphic is exciting. Huh. What is this movie?
X-15, which was an early sort of subspace aircraft.
And this is a Japanese movie or a...
This is actually a U.S. movie.
Oh, a U.S. movie. Yeah.
Mary Tyler Moore.
Yep.
Rob.
Great. Oh, it's. I'm going to have to see it.
Charles Bronson?
I don't think it's.
Oh my God, Richard Donner directed it. This is the guy that Arlene lived with in California.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah. It's Dick Donner. He went on. Oh, Howard Koch Jr. Yeah, Howard Koch. Dick Donner went on to direct The Omen.
Oh, really?
And also all the series with the big guy, Mel Gibson. With the black guy that did the
Lethal Weapon.
Yeah, the Lethal Weapon movies were his.
Huh.
He didn't do musicals by any chance.
No.
He didn't do Singing in the Rain or anything.
Oh, no. No, he did television work.
I've heard of him, and I'm trying to remember why I know that name.
Well, because he did The Omen and then that series.
X-15 is a 1961 dramatic aviation film that presents a fictionalized account of the X-15 research rocket plane program, the test pilots who flew the aircraft, and the associated NASA community that supported the program. X-15 starred David McLean, Charles Bronson, Mary Tyler Moore in her first feature film role, Kenneth Tobey, and James Gregory. The film marked the directorial debut of Richard Donner, who later went on to direct The Omen. And this film was narrated by James Stewart. Oftentimes the papers of Italian movie posters, French movie posters, and other countries tend to be very acidic. The Italian movie posters are no exception. They tend to yellow along the folio folds as the acid makes its way through the paper. I find that Italian posters turn brown faster than posters of other, say, American origin. It may be the type of paper, but the linen backing process helps to neutralize the acids in the paper because we add calcium carbonate to our wheat paste, and that creates an acid buffer. The acid molecule is surrounded by the calcium carbonate and isolates it so that it can't do any damage. This benefit probably helps the poster for about 50 years before it wears off.
Beyond the stars, in a search for the perfect archival blue. B-Fix in Space brings you action, adventure, friendship, betrayal,
master of the universe,
opera, and pop. And did I mention that I too am in the B-Fix in Space saga? B-Fix in Space, coming soon to the Posterfix channel.